Established in Udupi in 2014. I am happy that we are celebrating the 91st birthday of a great guru, a doyen in Hindustani music, as a violinist, as a great composer, Narayana Pandit Ji. Narayana Pandit Ji, as a performer, might not have been known in the field. Due to some inconsistencies in the physical health, he had to devote himself for composing bandishes at his 50s and 60s. That made him a great composer of Hindustani music as a bandishkar. He meant for novel ideas and innovative themes in the bandishes, leaving all the good old traditions, traditional thematic compositions, lyrics of bandishes. It is very surprising that Narayana Pandit Ji visited Udupi. It is so much coincidental that one of my students brought her guru, Narayana Pandit Ji, to my house. Dr. Sharada Bhatt by name, she was instrumental in bringing that Mahan maestro to my house to give a lecture demonstration on Hindustani music. My daughter Ranjani was with us, very young, and our family, the Latangi family as we call it, is known for Carnatic music. All the inmates of this house are Carnatic musicians. This Hindustani maestro, once he landed here, he was surprised to see my daughter listening to her Karahara Priya Raga, which was so much in tune with the Sur, which he identified immediately. I remember that he was in tears once he listened to this singing of my daughter, a Carnatic Raga. He said that this is an ancient voice. He was trying to identify a person who would have this voice in the entire India he has traveled. And he said, I have come across with that voice today. That was North meeting South in my house. A big Doyen met a small young artist of Carnatic music, Ranjani. And he even said that he would teach Hindustani music to my daughter, which very fondly she started learning under him. She started learning the bandishes, and she was really at the highest helm of her career once she started excavating the secrets of Sur, secrets told by Panditji. Panditji was so much in love with Ranjani that he was escorting Ranjani at his old age to Madras, and he lived with Ranjani there. Ranjani was able to understand the secrets of music only from Panditji, and which made Ranjani's music divine and first of its kind to scale very high in the field of Carnatic music. It is so coincidental that Narayana Pandit Ji recommended Srimati Devi to our family. So Srimati Devi got wedded to my son because of the recommendation of Narayana Pandit Ji. She was a Hindustani singer. She was learning under Narayana Pandit Ji. Now the North and the South started living together in Latangi, and thus we are here. Ranjani had to be taken out from the scene of this world by God because of a malady of emperor of maladies, which she had in her 30s, a cancer succumbed her to death. In 2013, she died. We became orphaned because of that. But we thought that we should do something to the cause of music because of her demise. We were not laid down by anybody. Everyone encouraged us, supported us, and we thought that we would make an attempt to revive our music more than earlier. So we thought Ranjani Memorial Trust could be established. This happened in 2014, and under the banner of Ranjani Memorial Trust, we have taught some of the Carnatic young talents. We have given guidance to many Carnatic musicians. We have given scholarships. We have given some incentives identifying the good talents in and around us in both Hindustan and Carnatic genre. And thus, we were finding ourselves so comfortable that we are doing something for the cause of music under this banner, which it will be very satisfying to the soul of Ranjani. Now, having had the privilege of being with such a great guru like Narayan Pandit ji, we thought that a man who had never come to the limelight has to be exposed to the world. Nobody knows why it has happened. There were 150 or more compositions or bandishes written by Narayan Pandit ji, but except that Dr. Sharada Bhatt of Dharwad published it in the form of a book in Kannada, nothing has come out except this work. Having some debts from Narayan Pandit ji, that he has taught my daughter, that he has taught my daughter-in-law, and we had some hundreds of hours of philosophical and musical discussions with Narayan Pandit ji, I thought that I have binding to do some work to remember him and show him to the world that there was one person like this. Narayan Pandit ji's, in memory of Narayan Pandit ji, we thought that we would give out a book in English or Hindi. We will record all the bandishes prepared, composed by him. And as far as possible, we will excavate and explore what he meant for raga, rasa, bhava, and rupa, raga, rupa, saundarya, and all that. So such kind of activities must take place. And we thought that instead of advising others, we ourselves started this venture. And it is a very humble attempt. As a first phase, we have asked our own daughter-in-law of Latangi House, Srimati Devi, to sing some 100 or more songs. She said that at least 50 she would sing at the first phase. We have done it. We have recorded it. And you are seeing some 50 songs from here onwards for 40 days from today. Today, we are launching 10 Panditji's compositions sung by Srimati Devi, and we are uploading it today with all respects and tributes to Narayan Pandit ji, and let the noble souls and noble thinkers of Hindustani field would receive this and get benefited, and let the bandishes of Narayan Pandit ji be very much disseminated to each and every household in the Hindustani field. So that's our purpose. We have found out that while doing this endeavor, to promote the music of Narayan Pandit ji, we have found that every one of the Narayan Pandit ji's disciples were so possessive of him that they thought that they would promote it. And I waited. But I did not see further progress. So instead of pinpointing others, I thought that I should first start first. And if they start, if all the disciples start disseminating Panditji's bandishes, we are really indebted to all such people and we are thankful to them. Let the Panditji's compositions go to every house and let the real novelty in such bandishes be relished by each and every of the everyone singer in Karnataka, in the Hindustani field. It's our wish. And as a Carnatic musician, a teacher, and a little bit of musicologist, as I can claim, I have all respects to Hindustani, and I have my own daughter-in-law who can really stand by me to support whatever knowledge that I have in Hindustani. You may relish what Srimati Devi would render it. Her rendering is so much precise, short, and very much clear to the notations Pandit ji gave to us. As far as possible, the correctness of such version has been taken care of. Her gurus are very much remembered. Today is 91st birthday of Narayan Pandit ji. She will remember all her gurus along with us and give the Guru Namana. Today is Narayan Pandit ji's Nada Piya Naman. Namaskar. Please lend your ears to listen to great Guru ji's bandishes and support us. Namaste.
Namaste. Today I feel very happy to be present here in front of you. Today is going to be a very special and memorable day for me, as today we are launching the bandishes composed by my guru, late Pandit Narayan Pandit ji. We are publishing it in audio visual format for the use of aspirants. It was our dream since many years to compile and publish his bandishes. I feel fortunate and proud to be identify myself as a student of Narayan Pandit ji. He has taught me many traditional bandishes, his own compositions, and also Kumarji's Nirgunis with lots of love and affection. In 2010, a well-known harmonium player and a composer himself, Dr. Chaitanya Kunte ji, with his friends Swapna Datar, a violinist from Pune, and Ravi Joshi ji from Mumbai, have come to Manipal to document Pandit ji's interaction. And Chaitanya Kunte ji has interviewed Pandit ji, and we all students have presented his compositions. This is the only documentation we have now, and we have uploaded it onto YouTube now. Now it is my father-in-law, Sri Arvinda Hebbar, the founder of Ranjani Memorial Trust, has initiated this project to record and publish Narayan Pandit ji's bandishes. Ranjani Memorial Trust, Udupi, is a trust founded in the memory of my sister-in-law, late Mrs. Ranjani Hebbar, who was also a student of Narayan Pandit ji. My father-in-law, Sri Arvinda Hebbar, was there with me in my each and every step from the beginning of this project. Hence, the project is here. Though I was trying to incorporate all the ideas taught to me by Pandit ji, in some moments, I was feeling like I need to learn and understand it again. In such moments, my present guru, Sri Ravi Kiran sir, who is also a senior disciple of Narayan Panditji, helped me a lot. My pranamas to him. Dr. Chaitanya Kunte sir was reminding me whenever I met him about the publication and recording of Narayan Panditji's bandishes. But it took long time to bring into reality. But all through these years, Chaitanya Kunte sir was there for me to support and guide in all possible ways. He has written an article on Panditji back in 2008 in Marathi, and it has got published in Sangeeta Kala Vihara magazine. Now he has given that article to put it on Ranjani Memorial Trust website. Actually, we have planned for a day-long program in the memory of Narayan Panditji, but because of this COVID, in this critical situation, we have requested him to record his speech and to send us. Now with this, we are posting his profound speech on Narayan Panditji, his music and his ideas and about his bandishes. We are indebted to him for this unmatchable speech. My sincere thanks to Dr. Chaitanya Kunte sir. Veteran musician, Dion of Music, the famous sarod player Pandit Raju Taranaji has shared his views on documentation of bandishes, tracing it from the great work done by Pandit Bhatkhandeji, and blessed us with his words. My pranamas to him, and we are uploading his video here. My husband Saranga has done all these videos out of his love and respect to Panditji. Panditji's thoughts on sur, lai, raga and lyrics were wonderful and special. He used to call his approach as Bhavasaundaryavada. Along with aspiring to reach that level which he expected from us, we are also trying to document his life, music and ideas in all possible ways. I pray the God and seek the blessings of my gurus for the success of this venture and to make my life with music, Ananda Yatra, that is joyful journey, as beautifully coined by Panditji himself. Thank you. Namaste. We are happy to launch a new YouTube channel called Nadapiya Narayana Panditji Bandishas. This channel has the bandishas composed by our guru, late Pandit Narayan Panditji. Each video has the audio recording, its script notation with a rare photo of Panditji. Narayan Panditji has composed close to 200 bandishas. Among them, we are doing the 50 bandishas now. Among them, 10 are in front of you now. Please listen to these bandishas, like and subscribe. Thank you.
Mata Bharani Nama Kachuja. ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾತ್ಖಂಡೆ ಅವರ ಆರು ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಕ್ರಮಿಕ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಮಾಲಿಕ ತಲಿಯ ಒಂದು ಸಾವಿರಕ್ಕೂ ಮೇಲಿನ ಬಂಗಶಗಳನ್ನು ಹಾಡಿ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ಇಂದುಧರ್ ನಿರ್ಗುಡಿಯವರು ಯಶ ಗಳಿಸಿದರು. ಈಗ ಜನಿ ಮೆಮೋರಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿಯವರು ಇದೇ ಇಂಥದ್ದೇ ಕಷ್ಟಕರವಾದ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಧೈರ್ಯದಿಂದ ಕೈಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೂ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಪಂಡಿತರ ಇನ್ನೂರು ಬಂದಿಶಗಳನ್ನು ಹಾಡಿ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಪಂಡಿತರ ಶೈಲಿ ವಿದ್ವತ್ತು ವೈಖರಿ ಇವುಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಸಂಗೀತೋಪಾಸಕರಿಗೆ ಕೊಡುವ ಮಹತ್ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿಯವರು ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ 50 ಬಂದಿಶಗಳನ್ನು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದದ್ದು. ಅವರ ಈ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಯಶಸ್ಸು ಒದಗಬೇಕು. ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಪ್ರೋತ್ಸಾಹಿಸಬೇಕು. ಅವರ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನದಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಲ್ಗೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು. ಒಳ್ಳೆದಾಗಲಿ. ಅವರ ಗುರುವಿನ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಶುಭಾಶಯ ಅವರಿಗಿರಲಿ. ರಾಜೀವ್ ಕಾಲಮ.
ನಮಸ್ತೆ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ರವಿಕಿರಣ್ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ್, ಹಿಂದೂಸ್ತಾನಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕಲ್ ವೋಕಲಿಸ್ಟ್. I am honored to speak a few words about my Guruji, Pandit Narayan Pandit Ji. Narayan Pandit Ji was an outstanding Vagyakar or a composer of Hindustani Bandishas. He has explored not only the different profiles in carving and shaping a raga, but also found out new vistas in building a unique Sahitya Shilpa. He invented new ways of expression in the content of the lyrics, perhaps because of the inspiration drawn from his mentor Guru Shri Kumar Ji. Pandit Ji laid emphasis to Bhava Saundarya in the lyrics he wrote. I believe that his compositions, which remained unknown and unseen for all these days, will be definitely recognized and accepted by the connoisseurs of Hindustani music and lay listeners alike. I had the good fortune of learning music from this great Guru Narayan Pandit Ji for 8 years. He taught me how to open the door to see the beauty of swara, bhava, rasa and the content other than the effervescent beauty of a raga in my singing. He changed my angle of looking at the bandishas and its handling. It was indeed an experience to sing his Abhinava Khayal bandishas. His high thought process and his handling of a bandish in a raga was so innovative that it will be a sacrilege if I say that I have learnt entirely his philosophy of music. But I tell you for sure that he has infused awareness of such subtle aspects in my music. It is most timely, at least now, that Ranjani Memorial Trust has taken a responsibility to disseminate Panditji's Bandishas to all the stakeholders of Hindustani music. This project aims at documenting at least some 100 Bandishas of Narayan Panditji and upload them to the YouTube. I am happy that I am also involved in this project as one among the senior students of Narayan Panditji. We intend to give them in 2 or 3 places where some of Sri Narayan Panditji's disciples are going to sing his bandishas. Major of them are sung by my talented student Srimati Devi. I believe that such versions coming from Panditji's direct disciples will have the real worth of original authenticity. And hence this project by Ranjani Memorial Trust should really be considered worthy of full support and appreciation. Ranjani Memorial Trust is remembering Narayan Pandit Ji so intense because of some indebtedness to him. Arvind Hepburn's daughter Ranjani had good fortune to associate herself with Pandit Ji. I know Ranjani as a family friend and as a very novel artist and a notable star in the Carnatic field. Pandit Ji taught her the secrets of raga music. Her voice became very pristine and divine. It was really a coincidence that Ravindra Hepburn's daughter-in-law also came under the folds of Pandit Ji. As a family friend of Hepburn's at Lathangi, I consider myself privileged as the Ranjani Memorial Trust has involved me in this project and given an opportunity to serve my esteemed guru, Pandit Narayan Pandit Ji. On the eve of his 91st birthday, we all pray for the peace to this great soul and invoke blessings from him. Thank you.
In the world of Hindustani art music, Vidwan Narayan Pandit will be remembered as an accomplished violin player, a bandishkar, and a gentle-hearted guru. His book Violin is also cherished as a major contribution to musicology in Marathi. Narayan Pandit was born on 23rd June 1929 in Gokarna in Karnataka. He belonged to a very Brahmin family, and his father Vigneshwar Shastri, mother Lalita, with 2 brothers and a sister, belonged to a traditional orthodox family from a small village called Gudamanteshwar in Karnataka. One of his ancestors wrote Muhurta Madhavi, the treatise on astronomy. This is indicative of the strong background of the traditional knowledge and intellectual inheritance that this family had. His maternal uncle was a renowned Pandit who was well versed in recitation of four Vedas. And similarly, his father, Vigneshwar Shastri, too was a Vedic scholar. Vigneshwar Shastri learned violin from Fidel Krishna Rao of Mangalore. He was a renowned violin player at that time in Karnataka. Vigneshwar Shastri later shifted to Mumbai and renowned scholar musician Professor B.R. Devdar appointed him as a violin teacher at Devdar School of Indian Music. Here he developed the technique of violin playing especially for Hindustani art music, and Vigneshwar Shastri contributed as a major propagator of violin in Hindustani music with training bright musicians such as Pandit V.G. Zog and Pandit D.K. Datar. Vigneshwar Shastri passed away in 1980 at the age of 80 in Mumbai. So this was about Narayan Pandit's father, Vigneshwar Shastri. I felt it is important to mention about Vigneshwar Shastri's contribution to Hindustani music as a violin player, because many people don't know much about Vigneshwar Shastri. Narayan Pandit spent his childhood in Mumbai. He had schooling at Ram Mohan High School, and he did bachelor's in political science and economics from Wilson College. Later he did LLB from Government Law College, and as a lawyer he successfully served at Mumbai High Court for not less than 35 years. Although law was his professional career, Narayan Pandit's real passion for music was always alive, and he invested his creative energy in music. Narayan Pandit got rigorous training in violin playing from his father, Vigneshwar Shastri. Panditji developed his style of violin playing and also gave solo violin concerts all over the country. At that time, the Devdar School of Music was a chief center or a cultural hub in Mumbai, and many musicians, vocalists, instrumentalists and also dancers used to gather there and share their musical knowledge and musical experiences. Panditji was largely benefited by this musical environment at Devdar School, and he picked up nuances of Gwalior, Agra and Jaipur style. He was also fortunate to have a fulfilling musical interaction with his friends and musicians such as Pandit Ratnakar Pai, Kishori Amonkar, Dr. Ashok Dharanade and also Pandit Ravi Shankar. As a violin player, Narayan Pandit accompanied many stalwarts at that time such as Omkarnath Thakur, Bade Ghulam Ali, Pandit D.B. Paluskar and many others. But the most influential musical personality was Kumar Gandhar. Besides being friends, Narayan Pandit used to accompany Kumar Gandhar on violin as well as Tanpura. He had an enriching musical interaction with Kumar Gandhar for many decades, in which he imbibed Kumar Gandhar's musical thoughts and his style of composing bandishes. Narayan Pandit did a great amount of study and research in violin, especially violin playing in Hindustani music. With constant encouragement and follow-up by his friend Dr. Ashok Dharanade, Narayan Pandit wrote a famous book, Violin in Marathi. This book was published in 1974 by Maharashtra Vidyapeeth Granth Nirmiti Mandal. This book is considered to be the most authentic and exhaustive book on violin in Marathi, because this book covers almost all relevant areas of study of violin, such as history of violin, its acoustics, its manufacturing, maintenance of violin, also playing techniques and playing styles of violin, the contribution of various musicians and their stylistic differences, and also he has given notations of many compositions suitable for violin playing. Brigadier S.G. Bhagwat translated this book into Kannada, but unfortunately it never formally got published. In the later half of his life, Narayan Pandit left Mumbai and got shifted to his homeland, Karnataka. Settling down in Udupi, he preferred to live in a peaceful and contemplative environment which was away from commercial world of music. He concentrated more on vocal music and started teaching vocal music to many budding artists. Lalita Hiregande from Shirsi, Ravi Kiran from Manipal, Sharada Bhatt from Dharwad, P. Srimati Devi from Mysore, Arpita and Annapurna Shambhag from Honnavar, and Gajanan Hepar from Bhatkal are some of his prominent disciples. Panditji suffered from many physical discomforts such as spondylitis, paralysis and asthma. But his cheery spirit and musical musings never diminished. He spent his last days at Nehakunje Hospital at Honnavar, and he left for the heavenly abode on 30th October 2017. In the second inning of his musical life, he blossomed as a composer. He composed about 200 bandishes with pen name Nadapiya. One might get confused with this pen name. Nadapiya is also used by Pandit V.R. Atole. But I think V.R. Atole Nadapiya and Narayan Pandit Nadapiya are two different musical personalities, and one can clearly trace this from their bandishes because they are uniquely different. Narayan Pandit expressed his musical thought through his bandishes in various forms such as Drupad, Khayal, Tappa, Tarana, Thumri, etc. His bandishes, though have some influence of Kumar Vidura's style, they have distinctive stylistic features and aesthetic flavor. One may say that Narayan Pandit is one of the prominent bandishkar in the musical school of Pandit Kumar Vidura. Apart from musical and philosophical thoughts, he has composed several bandishes on the usual theme of Devata Stuti, that is praise and portrayal of God and Swaris, and Shri Krishna's Leelas. He has used Braj Bhasha, that is dialect of Hindi, which is commonly used in bandishes, but he has also used some beautiful and rarely used words, lyrical imageries and themes. The words he used in bandishes are easily palpable and resonant with use of Dirgha Swaras, elongated and elastic vowels, and Mrudu Varnas, soft consonants. Most of the time, he composed bandishes of Bada Khayal and Chota Khayal on the same theme, so to keep a continuity in lyrical content. In some bandishes, he had challenged the so-called Raga Rasa theory by using unusual themes, but the thrust of bhava, emotive quality, has always remained important in Narayan Pandit's bandishes. His bandishes contain purity of rag, yet they point out towards some unusual phrases or unexplored areas of raga. Sometimes he has placed the sum on a picular note which is not found in traditional bandishes. The use of picular small taan patterns, khatka, gitakdi and pukar are some beautiful features of his compositions. Narayan Pandit's compositions are full of rhythmic lilt too. He has mostly composed in common talas such as Teetal, Ektal, Jhaptal, Rupak. But the way he treats the Avartan and Amar, the gate of arriving on sun, are exclusive in his style. Though he has composed Bada Khayals in Vilambit Ektal, but most of the time his Bada Khayals are in Rupak or Jhaptal. As the Avartan of Rupak and Jhaptal are comparatively short in duration, these bandishes gave us an opportunity to explore the rag in relatively condensed space and a quicker pace. The gait of his khayals in Rupak reminds me of khayals from Bendi Bazaar Gharana, especially composed by Usad Aman Ali Khan Sahib. In a bandish in rag Malkaons, he has used uncommon theka of 6 beats, Shat Tal. Let me explain that taal. Then, tere kita tu na dha ge na dha. Tere kita then, tere kita tu na dha ge na dha. Tere kita then. And this is very interesting example of how he treated some talas, unusual talas. I was indeed fortunate to interact with Panditji back in 2010, when I spent some time with him discussing his thoughts on music, his life experiences. I was deeply touched by his simplicity and kindness as a human being, and I was moved to see the firm musical philosophy in which he not just believed in, but he lived in without any compromises. In the interview sessions, he explained some of his stands and ideas along with the aesthetic points in his bandishes. That time, I photocopied his notebook containing his handwritten notations. And when I browsed through this notebook and analyzed these bandishes, I thoroughly enjoyed the musical content and expression in the bandishes. Now I am going to point out some salient features of Narayan Pandit's bandishes with aspect of exclusivity which I found interesting to share with all of you. In a Drupad bandish in Ragmalakams, he has portrayed Shri Ganesha. And in this bandish, he has tactfully mentioned the name of his father, Vigneshwar Shastri. Anatarupa Gauri Isita Gajavadana Lambodara Ekadanta Abhayahasta Vigneshwara Prathamanamana. He portrays a different kind of goddess Saraswati in his bandish in Rag Kamsadhvani. Here he has used more Sanskritized language to give beautiful visual imagery. He says, माता राजेश्वरी शुभांगी वागीश्वरी वाग्येयकारकी वागीश्वरी वाग्येयकारकी. That means she is one who gives inspiration to the वाग्येयकार्स. भावमयी अभिनय सम्राज्ञी नटराज प्रिय नृत्यमयूरी सत्यरूप शिवरूप सुंदरी युग युगतो योगिनी तपस्विनी नादपिया को पावन तोरे रुनझुन चरण कमल. So in this bandish, he has given a very different kind of visual imagery of goddess Saraswati. He has composed a beautiful bandish in Rag Nat in praise of veteran guru Puttaraj Gavai. In this bandish, Panditji has explained various aspects of Pandit Puttaraj Gavai's musical personality, and as we know, Puttaraj Gavai is a, in a way, saint musician of modern time. He says, धन धन भाग आज मेरे दर्शन करु पावन गुरु चरण कमल को मठ के महंत गरीब नवाज अनाथ बंधु वाग्येयकार नादपिया अर्पित सुर के भाव पुष्प पावन गुरु चरण कमल को. द नेचर ऑलवेज कॉल्स द कंपोजर्स एंड नारायण पंडित जी वॉज नॉट एन एक्सेप्शन टू दिस. ही हैज डिपिक्टेड द नेचर द सीजंस इन हिज बंदिशेस. His bandish in Rag Meghmalhar, set to Ada Chautal, depicts a fearful rainy season. Umand Ghumand Ghana Barasat, Sanananan Ati Ghor Pavan, Barasat Abha Meghari. Sagar Uchhayo Tandav, Sagar Uchhayo Tandav, Damini Damake Navad Dubhangat, Gheri Chamudisi Andhyari, Nad Piya Darapave. In a bandish in Rag Puriya Kalyan, he depicts a beautiful evening when sun sets in the background of seashore and moon arises on the sky. Manda manda chanda ugiyo sagar mein suraj dubi jata. Manda manda chanda ugiyo sagar mein suraj dubi jata. Chandra kiran sheetal manda pavana dekhat nadapiya mana bhavana. Sita was a character close to his heart, and he has painted various shades of Sita in his bandishes. In a bandish in Rag Lanka Dahansaran, a rarely heard rag, he has described Sita's love at first sight. Very unusual theme. Jab se dekhi siya akulai, man mein murat raghunandana ki. Tejo maya roop, suraj sam dekhat, sudhan rahi janaki, man mein murat raghunandana ki. In two compositions in Rag Vilas Khanitodi, he has portrayed Sita in two different situations. In the Bada Khayal, he asks Lord Rama, why did you abandon Sita? Was it right to do so with just because of the gossip of ordinary people? How come you forget that Sita accompanied you in the exile by withdrawing her pleasures? Hey Lord Ram, how can I call you Anathan Kenath? काहे त्यज दीनो रे ब्याही सती को सुनत लोगन की बात है रघुवीर कैसे भूल गयो रे सब त्याग साथ गई जीवन की नाद पिया तुम अनाथन के नाथ कैसे कहूं हे रघुवीर. बट इन द छोटा ख्याल Panditji depicts Sita in Ashokavan and her agony due to the separation with Ram. Bin badal barse bundariya, ghor virog man mein chhaye. Karat shok Ashokavan mein siya, karat shok Ashokavan mein siya. बरसत अविरत नयन नाद पिया कबहु देख श्री राम पद कमल. Another theme that always attracts composers is Shri Krishna's life events. Panditji too has composed some bandishes but giving some colorful shades. In a bandish in Rag Gandhari, he depicts birth of Krishna. But in a bandish in Rag Devgandhar, he has illustrated Yashoda's worry about Krishna. Nindirava ave na lalan ko kahu ki vako nazar lagi. Nindirava na ave lalan ko kahu ki vako nazar lagi. Rovat rovat palak lagi janu na main ka upao karu kahu ki vako nazar lagi. In Rag Malgunji, Narayan Pandit ji has depicted a nice walk or gait of Balakrishna. Runuk jinuk baje panjaniya, guterin chal Krishna kanhiya. Nadapiya ko ni ko lage, thumukat dekhat gwal balasanga, janani man ko ni ko lage. In Rag Paraj, he has explained the pangs of separation of Krishna in Gokul. All these events are suitably fitted in the coherent mood of Raga. In a bandish in Rag Adana, Krishna Krishna Japure, he has used Tara Madhyam in the Mukda itself, considering the Uttaranga Surup and energetic nature of this Raga. Besides the mythological themes, he has also composed bandishes on day-to-day events. His bandish in Rag Deshkar is illustration of meeting of childhood friend. More Mandir Ayori Ayo, Bala Sakha Achanaka Ayo, आंगन में झूला लगाऊं, बालापन की मीठी मीठी बतिया करत मन को रिझाऊं, मोरे मंदिर आयो रे आयो बाल सखा अचानक आयो. पंडित जी वॉज अ डिवोटेड गुरु एंड इन मेनी बंदिशेस ही हैज एक्सप्लेन द नुआंसेस ऑफ म्यूजिक टू हिज स्टूडेंट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन अ बंदिश इन द राग भीम पलासी ही एक्सप्लेन द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ राग रूप एंड इट्स एक्सप्रेसिव पावर. राग रूप महाकठिन तरल दुस्तर सुरलय संग भाव बनत ऐसे समझ लो. राग ताल संयोग अपार नाद पिया कैसे बनत भाव मधुर समझ लो. वी ऑल नो दैट भीमपलासी इज अ मध्यम प्रधान राग एंड इट गेट्स डेविएटेड टुवर्ड्स राग धनाश्री इफ वन गिव्स इंपॉर्टेंस टू स्वर पंचम. इन दिस बंदिश Narayan Pandit ji has placed the sum on pancham, but he has done it so tactfully that it doesn't sound at all like Rag Dhanashri, and the essence of Bhim Palasi is kept intact. In this bandish in Malkos, he goes down to Guru for giving knowledge of music. With keeping sum on Mandra Nishad, he has highlighted the introvert mindset expected in these lyrics. Sab jagat chhod kar सत सुर ढूंढत आई शरण तिहारी. ज्ञानी महागुरुदेव नाद पिया मांगत भीख सत सुर ढूंढत आई शरण तिहारी. इन द फॉलोइंग बंदिश इन राग देसी ही एम्फसाइजेस द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ डूइंग रादर देन टॉकिंग इन म्यूजिक. बहुत न बोलो बनत कछु नाही, बहुत ना बोलो बनत कछु नाही, साधन कर तब तेरो काम सफल होत, साधन कर तब तेरो काम सफल होत. कर्म बिन बात कछु बनत नाही, कर्म बिन बात कछु बनत नाही, साधन कर निरंतर तब काम सफल होवे तेरो. पंडित जी सेज डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम एंड डू साधना. इन दिस बंदिश इन राग जो बीती जात तोरे साधन के दिन, बीती जात तोरे साधन के दिन, मेरो लला मानो मुरी बात. बीते दिन अब न आवे, बीते दिन अब न आवे, साधन बिन ज्ञान नहीं पावे, नाद पिया मानो मोरी बात. दो पंडित जी वॉज अ स्पिरिचुअल एंड रिलीजियस पर्सन बाय नेचर, ही बिलीव्ड इन ह्यूमैनिटेरियन वैल्यूज देन ऑर्थोडॉक्सी. दिस रिफ्लेक्ट्स इन हिज बंदिश इन कल्याण. भटकत काय फिरे मनवा पत्थर के मठ मंदिर में तेरो ही मन में तेरो राम बसत है। दीन अनाथ की सेवा करो नित अपने दुख अपने पास अपने दुख अपने पास सुख और न को बांटो नारदिया कहते यही साची है। इन संबंधिशेष कंपोज बाय नारायण पंडित वन मे फाइंड सिमिलरिटीज विद ट्रेडिशनल बंदिशेस और पंडित कुमार गंधर्व बंदिशेस बट स्टिल ही सेज हिज ओन म्यूजिकल थॉट थ्रू दीज बंदिशेस। हिज बंदिश इन राग जय जयवंती तोपे वारी जाऊं इज मच सिमिलर विद ट्रेडिशनल बंदिश चेरी की नहीं हो नंद दुलारे बट ही हैज प्लेस्ड द सम ऑन मध्यम एंड द स्ट्रक्चरल डिटेल्स आर क्वाइट डिफरेंट। Similarly, his Bada Khyal in Ragnand, ye jo roop bane, is similar with traditional Khyal in Nand, Govinda Bheen Bajai. In a Chota Khyal in Nand, he has used the lyrics of Kumar Gandhara's famous bandish in Malhar, Jaajo Re Badrava. But he has used the melodic and rhythmic structure totally differently. One can find striking similarity with Kumaraji's bandish in Rag. श्री करण दे कछु लगावे विथ पंडित जी बंदिश इन तोड़ी कछुना करण दे ललवा एंड कुमार जी अनदर बंदिश इन कल्याण यार बेना इज वेरी सिमिलर टू पंडित जी बंदिश लाल मेरो ना आयुरी इन कल्याण। पंडित कुमार गंधर्व कंपोज्ड वेरी अट्रैक्टिव बंदिश इन राग केदार नंदा बट देर वॉज नो विलंबित कॉम्पोजिशन इन दिस राग। सो नारायण पंडित जी कॉम्पोज्ड अ बंदिश इन झपताल देखो सखी आज देखो भवन में आनंद छाए होरी। पंडित जी कंपोज्ड इन मेनी अनकॉमन एंड अप्रचलित और अधुना प्रसिद्ध रागज। हिज बंदिशेस इन सच रागज गिव्स अस अ क्लियर आइडिया ऑफ द राग रूप। फॉर एग्जांपल मन में समाये बैठी इन राग देवगिरी बिलावन और कैसे धरो धीर इन बिहागड़ा और सावरिया सपने में आयो इन राग जोकोंस। He composed in both Asa Gauri, that is Purvi Thad Gauri, and Shubri Gauri, that is Bhairav Thad Gauri. And as we know, Gauri is a Purvanga Pradhan Rag. Most of the bandishes explore in the Purvanga. But Narayan Pandit ji has composed bandish in Gauri with giving importance to Uttaranga. Apart from the form of Khayal, Pandit ji also composed bandishes in Drupad style, in ragas such as Kalyan, Shri, also in Kapi. There is a beautiful bandish in form of Sadra in the rag Jokhans. Niranjana, Nirakara, Nishara, Nirantara, Kohu Samana Nahi. In a Chaturang in the rag Gold Malhar, Dimiti Dimiti Nache Giridhari. He has done an intricate design of Saragam syllables of Tarana and Tabla with Dapada. So it is a full Chaturang. Narayan Pandit ji composed many taranas and his taranas, notable or remarkable taranas are in Raag Bhoop, Shyam Kalyan, Maru Bihar, Nand, Chandra Kaus, Jhinjoti, Bheem, Bheem Palasi. I remember that his tarana in Raag Shuddha Kalyan is very unique because he has placed some on Tar Shajja. It's unlikely in Raag Shuddha Kalyan. Also, Tarana in Raag Hamsadhwani is very unique because it can be sung in both Taras, either in Teental or Ektal. Narayan Pandit ji had a good command on Tappa and he has composed some Tappa and Tappa Anga Bandishes. In his Tappa compositions, he has used Braj Bhasha unlike the traditionally used Punjabi dialect. In a Tappa in Raag Kalyan, सावन आयोरी गदर में बन में आंगन में he has crafted some delicate phrases in very interesting manner. In his two tappas in Raag Bhairavi, he has placed some on Tar Komal Vishak. But both these tappas have very different kind of melodic structure. Pandit ji composed some Thumri Radhara compositions in Pilu, Khamaj, Maand, etc. And surprisingly, he also composed two Bidai Geets in Ghazal style. He composed a Balagit, a song for children in Raag Miyamalla. And this song is so simple yet beautiful and attractive that any child can sing Raag Miyamalla effortlessly. Interestingly, Panditji also composed few khayals and ghazals in Kannada, his mother tongue. Nine Dayasindhu in the Raj Shuddhakalam is a nice example of Chota Khayal in Kannada language. These compositions certainly direct us towards exploration of Raga, Tala and Kavya in a different way, which is aesthetically rich and poignant with unique bhava and kahan, that is an expressive way of pronunciation. Abhinav Bhav Bandish of Sri Narayan Pandit, a compilation of his some 150 bandishes, was published in 2009 by Karnataka University with initiative of his disciple Dr. Sharada Bhatt in Kannada. And I am happy that Panditji's bandishes have been recorded now and they are ready for publishing in an audio-visual format, which is more suitable to this contemporary situation. I congratulate the trustees and team of Ranjani Memorial Trust, Udupi, for taking up this wonderful project and publishing the videos of these bandishes containing both the notations and the audio on a YouTube channel called Nadapiya Bandishes. I wish that the aspiring vocalists in coming generations will be benefited with this publication and Narayan Panditji's bandishes will be more into circulation, so to enrich us musically, aesthetically and spiritually.